Even before its opening session, the Arab League summit in Kuwait City has already had disagreements. Ministerial delegations failed to agree on who should represent Syria. Algeria, Lebanon, and Iraq opposed granting the role to the opposition. So Syria's seat will remain empty. With no consensus over how or whether to help the rebels, there has been calls for a UN Security Council resolution.
We must do all that we can to urge the UN Security Council to live up to its legal and ethical responsibility under Chapter 7 of the UN Charter in order to enforce a valid and binding ceasefire. It's the only way to put an end to the systematic killing and destruction perpetrated by the Syrian regime against the Syrian people.
The other difficult issue is terrorism. Egypt and Saudi Arabia declared the Muslim Brotherhood a terrorist organization earlier this month. And Saudi Arabia, Bahrain, and the United Arab Emirates withdrew their ambassadors to Qatar recently over the Gulf states' refusal to shun the organization. The summit draft communique is expected to use general terms condemning terrorism, but with no specifics. The issue of Palestine used to dominate Arab League summits. But in this one, there appears to be nothing more than the usual rhetoric.
The Israeli army's savage attacks on Gaza and its unjust siege require a response from the international community. As an occupying force, Israel should be forced to honor the international resolutions and end its violations in Palestine.
Arab leaders have always been able to resort to broad terms to demand peaceful solutions in Palestine and elsewhere, or to stress the need for Arab unity. But the real issues are discussed behind closed doors and are usually never mentioned in the final communiques. The perceived threat of Iran could be one such issue. Long-standing rifts and rivalries between the Gulf states, another. Also, the course the Arab Spring has taken in Yemen, Libya, and Egypt. Mistrust and the lack of hope for consensus have also affected who shows up at these meetings. Qatar and Jordan are represented by their heads of state, but few others are coming. Absent are most of the North African and GCC leaders, including Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, Bahrain, and Oman. It appears the Arab world is at its worst stage of fragmentation. Mohammed Val, Al Jazeera, Kuwait City.